This conference will now be recorded.
Let's start. Hope it's audible to everyone. Okay. Right, so let's see the concept of joints. Okay. See, these joints are used for retrieving the data from two or more tables. Okay, joints are used for retrieving the data from two or more tables using single select query. Okay, so it is used for retrieving the data from two or more tables using single select query. So basically, we have two types of joints here. One is inner join, another is left outer join. Okay, joints are used for retrieving the data from two or more tables using single select query. We have two types of joints, inner join and what? Left outer join. Okay, to use joints between two tables, okay, if you want to use joints between two tables, there should be at least one logical related field. Between two tables, and this field should be compared as part of what? Select query. Okay, so if you want to use joints between two tables, there should be at least one logically related field. On class. Okay, so something like this. Table one dot field equal to table two dot field. Okay, so something like this, you have to compare by using what? On statement. On table one dot field is equal to table two dot field. Right, so let's understand the difference between inner join and what? Left outer join. Right, so see here, one second, let me wait for others to log in. Right. So the difference between inner join and left outer join is, assume like this, we have two tables, table A and table B. Okay, these are two different tables, and these two tables is having one logically related field. Okay, like here in table A we have four columns A, B, C, D, and table B has got some five columns E, F, G, H, I. So assume that these two columns are same. What is that? Here column name is D, column name is what? E. Okay, so the field names need not be same, but the purpose of the field should be what? Same. Okay, here also I said the two tables should have what? At least one logically related field. So when I say logically related field, field names need not be same, but the purpose of the field should be what? Same. In both the tables, that field should capture what? Same data. It should capture what? Same type of data, I mean to say. Okay. So in this scenario, assume that we have two tables, A and B. The logically related field between these two tables is what? D and what? E. So when I use inner join in my select query, I have to say table A inner join table B on what is the left hand side table here? A. What is the logical related field between the two tables? D and E. So A of D is equal to B of E. Okay. So whenever we use inner join in select queries, okay, what happens is each row of the left hand side table will be compared with all the rows of what? Right hand side table. I repeat, whenever we use inner join in the select query, each row of the left hand side table will be compared with all the rows of what? Right hand side table. So here, what is the first row in the left hand side table? A1, B1, C1, D1. What is the value of the logical related field D1? Okay. So it will compare with all the rows of right hand side table. When it is comparing, with what field it is going to compare? The logically related field. What is the logically related field here? E. So D1 is the value here. Okay. In the first row, the logically related field value is what? D1. Is it matching with any of the combinations here? Yes, it is matching the third combination. What is that? D1, F3, G3, H3 and what? I3. So since there is a matching row in the right hand side table, it will pick up that particular corresponding rows. It will pick up the row from left hand side and the matching row in the right hand side. So what is the left hand side row here? A1, B1, C1, D1. What is the matching row? D1, F3, G3, H3, I3. So I got that particular combination. Done. Then it will take the second row from the left hand side table. A2, B2, C2, D2. What is the logic related field value of D2? It is going to compare with the logically related field of what? Right hand side table. Okay, this D2, is it matching with any of the rows here? Yes, it is matching with the fifth row. It is matching with the fifth row. So it will pick up the corresponding rows from left hand side table and right hand side table. So here it is what? A2, B2, C2, D2. A2, B2, C2, D2. And what is the matching row? D2, F5, G5, H5 and what? I5. It will pick up that particular row. Then it will take the next row. Okay, third row it will take. What is the compared logically field value of D3? Is D3 is matching with any of the row in the right hand side table? Yes, it is matching with the fourth row as well as the sixth row. Fourth row and what? Sixth row. So it will take two rows, one after the other. First row is what? A3, B3, C3, D3. What is the first matching row? D3, F4, G4, H4, I4. Again, same row from the left hand side table. A3, B3, C3, D3. What is the other matching row? The sixth row. D3, F6, G6, H6 and what? I6. Done. Then, what is the next row here? This one. What is the logically field value? D4. Do we have any D4 in the right hand side table here? No, there is no matching row in the right hand side table. Since there is no matching row in the right hand side table, it will ignore the left hand side row also. It will not consider the left hand side row. So this row will be what? Ignored. This row will be ignored. So I didn't got any D4 here. It will ignore. Then again, fifth row. What is the compared field value? D1. Is D1 is matching with any of the thing? Yes, it is matching the right hand side table. So we'll pick up that A5, B5, C5, D1. What is the matching row combination? D1, F3, G3, H3 and I3. Done. Then next row. What is this value? D6. Do we have D6 in the right hand side? No. There is no matching row in the right hand side. So it will ignore the left hand side row also. So what is the... So whenever we use inner join in the select query, what is the concept of inner join? Each row of the left hand side table will be compared with all the rows of right hand side table. As part of that comparison, it will check the matching rows based on the logically related field value. If any matching rows are found in the right-hand side table, it will pick up that rows one after the other. Okay. If there is no matching row in the right-hand side table, it will ignore the left-hand side row table also. That is the concept of what? Inner join. Yeah, any questions? Is my voice is clear to everyone? Hello? Hello, is my voice is clear to everyone? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Right. Okay. Right, so let's see an example on what inner join. So those who are joined late, I repeat once again quickly. We are trying to discuss joins. So joins are used for what? Retrieving the data from what? Two or more tables using what? Single select query. So far we have used a select statement to get the data from only what? One table. Okay. So if you want to get the data from three tables, we used to write three different select queries so far. Now by using joins, by writing one select query, I can get the data from what? Two or more tables at a time. So we have two types of join, inner join or what? Left outer join. To use either of these joins in the select query, there should be one common field between the two tables. Means there should be one field which is logically related. When I say logically related, field name need not be same, but the purpose of the field should be what? Same. Purpose of the field should be same. Suppose assume that we have employee table. Okay, we have employee table, employee number, employee name, designation, and department number, DEPT number. So assume that we have a table what? EMP. Okay, what are the columns in this table? EMP number, ename, EMP desig, and what? Department number. Then assume that we have another table, department. Okay, in this table also I'll take D number, something, department name and location. So here the field name is department number. What is the purpose of this field? It stores what? Department number. In the department table also we have a field what? D number. Okay, this also stores what? Department number. Okay, department number stores department number. So even though the field name is different, here it is DEPT number, here it is D number, but the purpose of the field is what? Same. Both the fields will store what? Department numbers in the respective tables. So I can say these two are what? Logically related. So when you are using the joins in the select statement, out what you have to do? As part of the select statement, you have to use on statement, emp dot department number equal to department dot d number. You have to compare the logically related field between the two tables, emp department number equal to department number. So we have two types of joins, inner join and what? Left outer join. So if you use inner join, what is the concept of inner join? Each row of the left hand side, what is the left hand side table here? A. What is the right hand side table? Table B. What is the logically related field here? D and E. The field names are different, but the purpose of the field is what? Same. So when I use inner join, what happens? Each row of the left hand side table will be compared with all the rows of right hand side table. As part of that comparison, it will compare the logically related field. So what is this here? A1, B1, C1, D1. Okay, so here you are saying A of D is equal to what? B of E. What is the field we are comparing? D and E. So what is the value of D here? D1. Do we have any matching row in the right hand side? Yes, third row is matching. D1 is available here. So it will pick up that row. Left hand side row is A1, B1, C1, D1. Right hand side matching row is what? D1, F3, G3, H3 and what? I3. Then it will take the second row, D2. Do we have any matching row here? Yes, this row is matching. So it will take that row, A2, B2, C2, D2. And again, D2, F5, G5, H5 and what? I5. It will pick up that row. Then again, left hand side D3 is here. Do we have a matching row in the right hand side? Yes, two rows are matching. Fourth row and sixth row. It will take both the rows one after the other. What is the first combination? A3, B3, C3, D3. And again, D3, F4, G4, H4, I4 from right hand side table. Left hand side again, same row. A3, B3, C3, D3. What is the other matching row? D3, F6, G6, H6, and what? I6. The next row is what? D4. Do we have any matching row here? D4? No, we don't have D4. Since there is no matching row in the right hand side, it will not consider the left hand side row also for retrieval. It will ignore this row from the left hand side. It will not pick up for the output. Then again, D1. Do we have D1 here? Yes, this row is matching. It will pick up that. A5, B5, C5, D1. D1, F3, G3, H3, I3. Then again, D6. Do any matching row here? No. Since there is no matching row in the right hand side, left hand side row also will not be considered for retrieval. This is a concept of what? Inner join. Okay. Hope it's clear to everyone. Any questions?
You mean to say first, when it gets the first time it matches, it will not search for the again the same record from the table A to table B. Only first time when it matches, that's all.
No. If you take this one, third row, D3 is there. D3. Okay, so how many matching rows are there? Two rows are matching. Fourth row and what? Sixth row. So it will take both the rows, A3, B3, C3, D3. What is the first matching row? D3, F4, G4, H4, I4. Again, same row, A3, B3, C3, D3 from left hand side. What is the other matching row? D3, F6, G6, H6. So it will take all the matching rows one after the other.
Okay.
Is it clear? Yeah. If there are 100 matching rows in the right hand side, it will take all the 100 matching rows from the right hand side table one after the other. If there is no matching row in the right hand side table, even the left hand side row also will be ignored. It will not be considered for retrieval. Okay. Yeah. So let's see an example on this inner join. So I want something like this. What I want, okay, we have another type of join, what? Left outer join, okay? It is also similar to inner join only, but the only change is, in case of inner join, if there is no matching row in the right-hand side table, even the left-hand side row also will not be considered. But in case of left outer join, even if there is no matching row in the right-hand side table, it will still pick up the left hand side row and the right hand side column values will be filled with the default values. Numeric data types to zeros and character data types to space. So for example, so it is similar to inner join. Now let us focus on D4. So we have A4, Z4, D4. What is the value of the logically related field? D4. Do we have any D4 in the right hand side in the column E? That is the field we are comparing. Do we have any D4 in the right hand side table? No. So even though there is no matching row in the right hand side table, it will still pick up the left hand side rows here. I'll get A4, C4, D4. Then right hand side, I don't have matching row. So it will fill the right hand side columns with what? Zeros and what? Space. So numeric data types to zeros and character data types to what? Space. Even if you observe D6 here, we don't have D6 in the right hand side table, but it will still pick up the left hand side table. Right hand side will be filled with what? Default values depending on the data types. So in case of left outer join, always you'll have more records. Okay, always you'll have more records. So when do we go for left outer join is when you want to retrieve each and every record from the left hand side table, we'll go for what? Left outer join. When do we go for inner join? When you want to pick up only matching rows, between the two tables, you will go for inner join. Left outer join means it will retrieve what? All the records from left hand side table. If there is any matching row in the right hand side, it would pick up that combinations one after the other. Even if there is no matching row also, right hand side column values will be filled with what? Default values. Numeric data type to zeros and character data type to what? Space. So I can say left outer join will always have more records compared with what? Inner join. Because in case of left outer join, it will not ignore any of the left hand side table records. You consider all the records. Hope it's clear to everyone. Any questions?